Hello there, I'm Milad Musavi from Maya HDT. Today I'm going to show you how to extract fluid volume in Simcenter 3D. Geometry preparation and extracting fluid volume are one of the first steps in CFD analysis. In Simcenter 3D, you can achieve this goal for all geometries with different approaches depending on the complexity and number of components. These features are easy to use and save time. The approaches are Boolean operations, where you can unite, subtract parts, or do other geometric modifications. Synchronous modeling, where you can easily modify the geometry by deleting, moving, replacing faces, or other actions. And Simcenter 3D intelligently and accordingly modifies the geometry. For more complex geometries, surface wrapping and immersed boundary method, in short IBM, are available. In this video, we focus on Boolean operation. What we have here is an assembly of an electronic box with a number of components inside. The first step is to create a new component in the assembly and make it a work and display part in here. Then use a wavelength feature to create associative copy of the original geometries. Let's go ahead and hide the original parts and make the cover and cases translucent by going to View, Edit, Display, and make it translucent. The next step is to create a unite from the case and the cover. So we select case and the cover. We're not going to keep the tool or the target. And the next is, let's create another unite from the board and the components. Select all the components by drawing a box. The next step is to create an extrude from the box. We're going to change the filter to face edges and select the bottom face and reverse the direction. For the end criteria, let's select until selected. Let's create the subtract to extract the fluid volume. Select the extrude as a target, and as a tool we use the case unite part. Click OK. Let's repeat this for the board and components. So we do the same thing again and select board and component unite as the tool. Now the fluid volume is extracted with a few steps, really easy. Let's make it transparent and see the internal. So you can see the fluid is extracted easily with a few clicks, and it's pretty simple. The next thing I would like to show you is how the associative copy works. So basically, since we have associative copy, if you go to the original part and change something in the original part, let's say for example pull a face of one of the components in here, you can see the fluid part is also updated automatically without any extra effort. So it's really time saving if you want to do quick change.